Well, another exciting night of hockey that the Devils unfortunately end up on the wrong side of. Welcome back to the channel, everyone. My name is Trevor, as always, and tonight I will be going over the 4-3 overtime loss to the New York Islanders. This is the New Jersey Devils post-game recap. Let's get with it. So, Devils and Islanders, Devils playing last night in Detroit, come home to face a Metro Division opponent. I'm surprised it wasn't more packed tonight. It was a little late for a Friday with these two teams playing each other. But then I realized, hey, dummy, tonight's game one of the World Series. So there's bigger priorities at hand than a regular season game on a Friday night in October, with the World Series being New York versus LA. So it is what it is. Islanders get going quick, though. Very quick. Less than 2 minutes into the game, they lead 1-0. I'm thinking, oh boy, here we go. Going to be a long night, because we sure know how these Devils play on the second halves of back-to-backs, and it ain't pretty. So, Islanders get off to the 1-0 lead. And then, who else? Oh, captain, my captain, Nico Hischier, man. This guy is insane right now. He's basically said, boys, put the team on my back, and I will take you. I'm going to drag you. And he is sure doing that right now. Tied now for the league lead in goals, along with Nikita Kucherov in Tampa. So, eight goals each for those guys. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Yeah. 1-1 then, but unfortunately for the Devils tonight, it was a case of they just couldn't get even. Every time they thought, okay, we got them right where we want them, nope, they give up another goal. And that's what they did. 2-1 Islanders at that point, and that goes into the second period. Curtis Lazar ties the game at 2-2, but then 3-2 right after. It's not going to cut it. 23 goals they've given up now in their past four games. And yet they're scoring at an insane rate themselves. The Devils are averaging 4 goals a game. You gotta find a way to win. But unfortunately they can't, and we'll get to it. So 3-2. Islanders going into the third, and it's dragging out at that point. I'm like, yeah, the Islanders have this on lock. They're playing great defensively, but Devils pull Jake Allen, and Jesper Bratt finds one, a mad scramble in front of the net, and ties the games at 3. So, I'm thinking, all right, here we go, overtime again. What will we get? And, well, the Devils got possession, and I thought the puck went in. It was on my side of the ice. I saw it hit the side of the netting, and I thought, oh, my God, that went in. I was standing, and most of the arena stood up, too. Unfortunately, looking at the replay on my train ride home, it hit the crossbar. I thought it was in. It wasn't. Wasn't even reviewed. And then a couple of seconds later, the Islanders end the game themselves. So 4-3, a final. Devils get another overtime point, lose a point. I got to give them credit in this department in the fact that usually in these games, the second half and back-to-backs, the team usually rolls over and dies. But tonight they fought. They got it to overtime. I know the goal wasn't pretty, but got to give them that. They at least fought and got to overtime. Should they have won? I guess maybe. I don't know. It's tough because we were just coming back the whole game. But at least you gave them a fight. So it's a start. But now Sunday, you have to find a way to win. Sunday is the must-win game against Anaheim. You have to find a way to do it, because if you lose and you're heading off to the Pacific Northwest of Canada on a losing on what would be a 5-game losing streak, right now it's 4, then you're really starting to tempt fate. So now the Devils are officially under 500. So 5-4-2, I would believe. Yes, 5-4-2 is the record now. So counting the overtime losses, they are now under 500. So we'll see what happens Sunday, the last home game of October, and that'll be it for a while, for the next week or so. So there you go. That's going to do it tonight from me. I'm mad, but hey, they got it to overtime. What else do you want from a team on the second half of a back-to-back? So it is what it is, and hopefully Sunday they can finally get that win. And I need it too for my sanity. So yeah, Sunday will be the next video. Thank you all for watching this one. My name is Trevor. I will see you for the next one.